The first ever interstellar object in the solar system might be an artificial light sail sent to look for signs of life, it's claimed. In a study released on Thursday, astronomers at the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics published their observations of an interstellar object known as Oumuamua. According to the scientists, the rock, which is the first observed to enter our star system from another, received an unexpected boost in speed as it passed through the inner solar system last year. Because the object seems to exhibit qualities associated with both asteroids and comets, the astronomers have speculated its unusual acceleration might be as a result of a light sail of artificial origin being pushed by solar radiation. The study could solar radiation pressure explain Oumuamua's peculiar acceleration? Was conducted by Shmuel Bialy, a postdoctoral researcher at the CFAS Institute for Theory and Computation, ITC, and Professor Abraham Loeb, the director of the ITC, the Frank B. Baird Jr. Professor of Science at Harvard University. In the report the astronomers wrote, considering an artificial origin, one possibility is that Oumuamua is a light sail, floating in interstellar space as a debris from an advanced technological equipment. The asteroid was first spotted by the Haleakala Observatory in Hawaii on October 19 last year. The strange cigar shape of the object and its unusual behavior led many to speculate that it might be an alien artifact. In the year since, debate has raged in the scientific community as to whether Oumuamua is a comet or an asteroid. The object appeared to speed up as it left the solar system, suggesting it had emitted materials from its surface after being heated by the sun in a way consistent with a comet. However, because it did not go through a similar process when it was closest to the sun, Bialy and Loeb have argued it is in fact a light sail, a form of spacecraft that relies on radiation pressure to generate propulsion. Loeb told Universe Today, Oumuamua could be an active piece of alien technology that came to explore our solar system, the same way we hope to explore Alpha Centauri using Starshot and similar technologies. The alternative is to imagine that Oumuamua was on a reconnaissance mission. The reason I contemplate the reconnaissance possibility is that the assumption that Oumuamua followed a random orbit requires the production of 10 to the power 15 such objects per star in our galaxy. Karen Meach, an astronomer at the University of Hawaii's Institute of Astronomy and co-author of the study, suggested that dust grains on the surface of most comets had eroded away during Oumuamua's journey through interstellar space. She said, "The more we study Oumuamua, the more exciting it gets. I'm amazed at how much we have learned from a short, intense observing campaign. I can hardly wait for the next interstellar object." Oumuamua is less than half a mile in length and is currently traveling away from the sun at about 70,000 miles per hour as it heads toward the outskirts of the solar system. In another 4 years, it will pass Neptune's orbit on its way back into interstellar space.